from Egypt to set the scene, if I may say so. Tell us a little bit about the background, the objectives and the expectations they had when preparing this training seminar. So could I ask Fawad Khalaf and Hani Khelal to present?
Thank you, Arthur. Dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, let us at the beginning of the workshop, on behalf of the all the participants, thank the organizers, Barcelona University, the agency, Arthur, all the people who have been working hard in order to set up this workshop. In fact, I'm replacing my colleague, Dr. Mohammed Mijahid, who was not able to take the visa and coming, and he has prepared all the work with Dr. Fuad Khalaf. Dr. Fuad Khalaf is a professor at Cairo University Faculty of Engineering. He has been working since long time in the reform of higher education and other business. Fuad.
Thank you, Dr. Hani. I would like first to thank the University of Barcelona and then Tempus Group. Thank also the audience, the distinguished audience. You came from about 9 countries and 3 organizations, and you most probably spared for us a very precious time to come and work together. The beauty of this seminar that we are going to work in a group, not for this time, maybe, and also definitely, as Mr. Kemp said, for more months and maybe years to come. Thanks for the organizers. I saw that we are 18 persons worked and this crowned by your presence. I would like to introduce Dr. Hani Khelal. Probably all of you know him. Graduate of mining engineering, same department as mine, and I'm in petroleum, he's in mining, in the mid-70s. And I think his career was very distinguished and flourishing, and then he, you know, that's all in the presentation. Let me go through the talk, but not...
Let me maybe, Dr. Fuad, say to our colleague that it seems that the topic of this workshop is simple. It looks simple, but it's very complicated. But I think we can make it easy if we agree on principles. And I think some of us were in Lisbon with you, Arthur, and we were talking about internationalization. And I think to a great extent, what we are talking today, equivalence, recognition, etc., is highly linked with what we call the internationalization of higher education. Fine.
So our talk will address first a certain introductory concepts. I mentioned here the number of slides. They will not have a lot of them. It's only 12. They are spotted on the wall next to you there. And maybe also we will terminate with some expectation that we will ask you to volunteer. We seek your participation to try to materialize this in the near future and also for the coming. Of course, there are challenges, and we terminate by indicators of success for this meeting or for our following work. Let me a few words about the background of the idea. In September last year, Dr. Mohammed Mijahid and myself went to a meeting in Belgium, and we were talking about here seminars to develop. So we talked about, we felt that there is a problem here of equivalence gap, a gap between qualification between the South and the North. This gap, with do nothing, is going to probably accelerate. The, probably in the past, there was no problem in the 50s, maybe in the 70s, but with the globalization, with the acceleration of pace of technology and change, this gap increased. There were some individual efforts here and there, but were not maybe coordinated. So the objective here is try to initiate some kind of a coordination or synergizing the effort in order to reduce the gap from accelerating up to bring it to something tolerable, something acceptable. With moderate effort, yes, but with synergized effort, it is commendable. We should synergize our effort to reduce this gap because staying as we are now, it's a waste of human resources in our opinion. With this background, we felt that equivalence, talking about equivalence, fits within the broader goal that Mr. Kemp mentioned about modernizing higher education and increasing the quality of the outcomes or the outputs of it. So our broader goal, we achieving equivalence between comparable, not identical, just because comparability would allow us to turn diversity into an advantage. We don't need to have identity of courses and programs and certification. Okay, this goal, maybe our objective, a little bit minor, maybe in the next year or a few months to come, would like to set up a process to help us define and refine, if possible, strategies for equivalence between the MEDA and the MEDA HEE system, I mean both the South and the North. Our scope, of course, will be in these 2 days, limited to equivalence. Qualification also we will talk about. We may need to define, I mean, this is our understanding, Dr. Hilal and myself, about, say, equivalence, but sometimes there are some divergences here and there. We need to iron out these differences, or at least to have a common understanding of what we are talking about. Equivalence, in our opinion, is the result of a process, systemic process, that links together comparable, as I said, not identical qualification. These qualifications are issued by different systems, different internal within the country sometimes, or external. Maybe in this case, we are talking between countries, between South and North, and between the South MEDA and the North MEDA countries. Okay. Equivalence here, we try to say it is tied to ILOs, but ILOs itself is not enough. We have to set up a quality assurance, quality control. If this is guaranteed or this is agreed upon, it leads to qualification. And it leads to a degree, and maybe after that it leads to a certificate or certification.
Fuad, I think here is this is something that we have to agree on. There is a difference between equivalence between degrees, it means piece of papers that we will certificate that we will issue, and between equivalence of qualification. Okay. And sometimes some people would go beyond that and saying that equivalence of qualification means recognition. I think this is, we need to debate about it. We have to have all European and non-European, Mediterranean, Arabs, etc., agree on this concept, because based on this concept, we will proceed later on.
Okay, as Dr. Hani said, he mentioned the word,
I'm Hani.
Okay, Hani, with Y, not with I. As you mentioned, talking about qualification degree and recognition. In our opinion, equivalence comes before recognition, not recognition before equivalence. okay, this is, if this is going to we agree upon, then we have the outcome is will be simplified, will be no problem. Accreditation and recognition, as I said, will be much more easier if we agree on the terminology and the first part of it. Equivalence, therefore, is four programs, four degrees, and four certificates. And when these are realized, it leads to recognition and it leads to accreditation, maybe first or recognition. Okay. About qualification, Dr. Hani, you need to probably say a few words about it.
Yes, maybe qualification. We need to identify the qualification. Is it outcome of a program of learning? Is it a proof of what you have gained or you will gain, a student will gain? It should certify beside the program some sort of knowledge that the program has given to the student, in addition to some skills. Is it a measure of intellectual capacity? Something that we need to know, because by the end, what we need to do is to have a qualification, a framework of qualification, and if we agree on the frameworks of qualification among the other systems, I think this will facilitate the mobility, the recognition, everything later on.
Okay. I think all of this should repose on certain values we have to be aware of and we have to admit it, because our systems are diverse. I don't want to use the word different. Different is negative. Diversity, we can turn it into something positive. Countries implementing this recommendation on voluntary basis. They have to tailor this to their environment. This is a basic value. Equivalence should be fair. Fair, it means a win-win deal. Both parties, whether the issuing the degree and the other is accrediting it or recognizing it or is making it is comparable, both parties should win. A win-lose deal is not viable. A win-win deal is a viable deal also. Equivalence facilitates choice of career and development. We need to render this equivalence something to improve flexibility and movement and selection of career, part of human rights. Diversity should be respected. Respected because of difference in languages, sometimes differences in beliefs. Well, that's why we should use the word comparability and not identity of factors or parameters. The equivalence should be based on sincere, synergized effort. That means every step adds value to the other. And we should develop independent and flexible approaches. This will be the result of all of these integrating the values in our approach. Okay, we have so far covered this introductory part. Let us maybe talk about our expectation of this meeting, how we are going to approach this action or this assignment to us. We expect
this is the task of Arthur. It's not our task. Now let us agree on that by the end of this, you know, by the end of tomorrow afternoon, we have to agree to have something in hand. Otherwise, it will not be accepted by anyone. We have to agree on a terminology. We have to, all of us should go home with a definite, concept and understanding of some terminology. When we say something, we should all agree on this terminology, because the terminology in this field is very vague. Let us agree on that. This is our first task. Second task. We know that there is, I'll talk in my talk about it, about the Mediterranean network. There is existing on paper, and or I don't know if it is active or not, but we will talk about it. We need to have a sustainable network. We need among us, with the support and help of the agency and other organization present here, to agree on, say, how we can sustain, first, activate, and second, sustain this network. There is many ways that we need to initiate to have the common practice. Every one of us has a practice, has an experience. We would like to share this experience and initiate new ways of this common experience. And we need to put indicators. We are all scientists. We need to put indicators and milestones for the future of our work. This, what we have put here as the expectation of our workshop, is some indicators or milestones for us. But we would like to put indicators and milestones for the next year, for example, to get out of the dilemma of equivalence and recognition in the Mediterranean.
Let me specify that these are tailored to equivalence. Maybe there are some bigger projects similar to this network, for instance. Then how we introduce our part on equivalence and integrate it into a larger network for the Tempus activities. We need to concentrate on equivalence and make use of what's available resources we can build on and make use of it. We are not going to start from zero. Something is there and we need to integrate.
Another point, is it possible that we could, maybe would agree or come up with a methodology during the 1.5 day, is it possible that we can do a methodology, a procedure that we may all use? Let us try. And finally, can we have, maybe if the methodology or a common procedure to agree on 1.5 day might be tough, but could we have a checklist? Could we get out with a checklist saying that in order to be sure that we are on the right track of equivalence, this is a checklist like the checklist for the organization of this workshop, you know, that the checklist that we everyone went through. Can we do it? And last but not least is a database. I think and this we would talk about the database later on. We don't need to make a database of what has been recognized or considered equivalent in some countries. It means not the Bachelor of Engineering in Egypt or in Cairo University has been equivalent to the Bachelor of Engineering in Vienna, for example. This is not our task. We need to have a database of the procedures, a common practice, difficulties, and I think I got a report from the internet about the experience of the Nordic countries. Maybe time now is not enough to explain it, but we will come back to this experience, in that even if some countries have the same, almost the same higher education system, the Nordic countries, the three Nordic countries had almost the same system. When they are dealing with equivalence, they have different views. And I think database will facilitate this experience.
We will distribute to you after this talk four pages in which we collected something related to ILO, something related to the Nordic experience, something related to taken from and adapted and we render it generic from tuning, from also certain countries that are advanced in the equivalence like in Nordic and the Australia and all the countries around. So all this, we grouped it in four pages, we'll distribute it around. Of course, covering this seven expectation may be very optimistic and we cannot solve it in one or two days. So what we did, we spotted on the wall over there, and Dr. Yasser will distribute to you pages. We would like people to volunteer. Volunteer in starting up and initiating something that we can talk about after we leave this place and we go home. We need leaders for the topics, because
champions?
Topics without champions, yes, topics without leaders may not be synergized. I already have some names. Volunteering on number one, we have number two, Mr. Salheen. It doesn't mean he can participate. He can participate and elect among us a leader for the topic, a coordinator, Mr. Pierre Gideon from Lebanon. He wants to initiate, share in this how to develop common practices, because this also serves part of his other work. He would like to share this because it has something to do. And we would like all of you, we would like here all the South MEDA to participate in this. And would you please either fill in, put your name on the one that Dr. Yasser is going to distribute, or very simply go on the back and write your name on the back.
I think Fad, maybe we would give you some time to listen to different talks, and maybe before the end of today, because tomorrow is the experience of countries, and I think today we will hear about the different experience and some we will debate some. A terminology, some experience, procedure, etc., and maybe after lunch or before the dinner tonight, maybe each one of you would choose a topic that he would or she would contribute to this, and we would ask Arthur and we would ask our colleague from the agency to add some European experts as well, in order to have something that is solid for the future.
Our plans is to show this tomorrow in the closing session. We will show this and say here who are the volunteers. So you have your time. We have time to you talk in between, and by tomorrow in our talk
we have to finish.
Okay.
Well, thank you very much. You have in fact given us a little time to applaud you. First of all. And secondly, you've given us quite a list of things to do. I suppose that the two of you will be ready to act as resource persons over the period of today and tomorrow. I think that during the panel discussion before the end of today's session, we can start collecting ideas both from the colleagues that are here from the Mediterranean countries, as well as from maybe some or the other of our non-Mediterranean experts. And as you say, we will see how far we can get by the end of tomorrow. I do hope that we can fill most of the slots, in fact. Yeah. What I think is very interesting is that it's a demand-driven initiative, where you say, okay, this is what we need, this is what we want to achieve. Developing a common methodology, in fact, will serve as an example maybe for other similar processes in this area. So I suppose all of us are quite ready to take up the challenge and to support you in whatever we can do. We will. In the course of this morning, on the one hand, we will have the contribution by the representative of the Union for the Mediterranean, who will be next, and then we will have the first non-Mediterranean keynote, if I may say so, by Volker Gemlich. And again, we will try to synergize and to bring together ideas and really try to get as far as possible. If we If we don't succeed 100%, I think it doesn't matter, but things should be on the move after this very session, right? Okay, so thank you very much. I think we, and you can always then go and look at the copies of the slides on the wall. So when you start thinking and when you start working, and when there is something where you want to